requirements for the lighting system. So primarily dictated by the function of the space of the task that is being performed within it. So lighting can happen in an area which can be empty, open space, or it can be done, it is done for a specific application where a specific process or task is happening. So in pharmaceutical lab, there will be laboratories where there is a clean room requirement. So that purpose will be different from electrical substation requirement. So we have to understand the criticality or the requirement of the lighting for that purpose, right? So in many areas, there has to be a requirement that a very fine granules has to be checked with respect to color and quantity. So for that area, a specific clean room or a specific designed lighting has to be done. However, for substation, that requirement will not suit the purpose. So there the requirement or the requirements are altogether a different purpose. So there the lighting design has to be designed based on the requirement of a substation, neither a clean room requirement. So that is very, very important point. Second most important point is the lighting level and the color rendering requirements. A very, very important point. So API RP 540, which I discussed in the last slide, specifies the lux level requirement for petroleum processing units. So all petrochemical oil and gas projects refer to that particular standard API RP 540. In absence of a client specific requirement to check that what is the lux level required for a warehouse, what is the lux level required for a process plant, what is the lux level requirement for a control room, what is the lux level requirement for a OHC room. So all those are broadly defined in that standards. So in India also we have IS 6665 for industrial application. So for Indian projects we refer to IS 6665, where in similar fashion the lighting lux level requirements are broadly classified for a particular area of application. So how these lux levels are defined, as I said earlier, so there are two broad ways how these lux levels are designed. So if you are working for a particular client or a customer, so they have their own standard design or standard working procedure. So they can suggest their standard lux level that they would like to maintain in their process units or buildings. Otherwise, in absence of that, we can refer to the international standards like API R40 and IS 6665, which gives us the confidence or the standard values or the best engineering practice lux level values that we can utilize for a particular project. So in color rendering requirements, so it's mostly applicable for indoor areas and it can be grouped as per the CI requirement numbers.